Hello and welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel if you're new here. If you like what you see, don't forget to like and subscribe. It helps the YouTube algorithm know that the content is useful and promotes it to others. If you don't like it, let me know about it in the comments. If you still don't have a Star Citizen account, use my referral link in the description below or the code on screen to snag yourself some extra starting credits. Now on with the video. In this video, I'll demonstrate some delivery missions. We'll start out by opening the Mobi Glass and going to the Contracts Manager Delivery tab. So, since I haven't done any deliveries on this account yet, the first step will be a single pickup, single drop-off. Sounds like a good basic one. We'll go ahead and track. Then we just need to jump in our ship. I'm going to cut the video here to jump out to space. From there, I'll let the rest of the video play at real-time speed to demonstrate how long it'll realistically take to complete a contract. This video has the single box entry contract and a follow-up for three boxes after it. When you've chosen to track the mission, it will give you AR HUD markers identifying where to go for pickup. After you pick up your delivery cargo, you'll receive a new marker for the delivery point. So we'll just go ahead and head over there. When you're landing at some of the moon outposts, they may have landing pads. You can use them if you'd like, as they allow you to refuel, repair, and restock if you need. If you have a large ship, I would suggest utilizing a pad as there's less chance for the ship to tilt due to uneven terrain. But you can also land anywhere you want if you feel it's more convenient to get in and out quicker. When you get closer to your pickup or drop-off point, you might see the marker move. This is a nice as it will let you identify which building your location is in case there are multiple ones, like in this video.
Engines off.
Now I'm just going to go straight for the package. If you're doing this on your own, you can also look around the different buildings for some loot crates in case there's any good stuff that you want to keep. I could just pick up some drop-offs. They're either going to be out in the open like these shelves, or sometimes there'll be a vending machine-like device as you'll see later. Now that we've got our package, we just take it back to our ship. As you can see, it's already given us a marker for where we're going to go drop it off. I like to use the place option instead of just dropping it. Sometimes the physics simulation can get pretty aggressive. Though in the Aurora here, place doesn't seem to be working too well. Now we just need to get out of atmosphere so we can quantum to our drop-off. I'm gonna have to jump around here to find a marker. And we'll use the star map to plot our next jumps to the destination. As I said, we can use the pads or just land wherever else might be convenient.
Engines are off.
Just grab our box and head off to the drop-off point. In this case, it's one of the vending machines I mentioned, so we locate the appropriate button for drop-off and click it. Then insert the box when the door opens. Once you see the ID of the box move to the drop-off point, you can leave as it will register the box is delivered. You don't have to wait. And that is the completion of our first delivery contract. And again, if you want, you can look around, see what's in the different crates. See if there's anything worthwhile. You can put it in the local inventory, and then when you get in your ship, you can transfer it from the local inventory into your ship inventory. And a med gun, you can grab those here sometimes. Tractor beam attachments for the multi-tool. I don't see any multi-tools here though. Clothing, drinks, all kinds of stuff sometimes. Now we check the contracts manager again and see we have more delivery options available to us. These will be three items. Either pick up three at one location and deliver to three separate locations, or pick up at three separate locations and deliver to one location. It's also worth taking the time to look at where the pickups and drop-offs will be. Sometimes you might have a pretty large distance between them. You'll have to decide if it's worth your time to do that or not. I'm going to be taking the first one as it has two pickups on the same moon, with the final drop-off in Hurston's atmosphere. Since I know traversing Hurston's atmosphere is slow, I want to spend as little time as I have to there. So having multiple points of pickup or drop-off there are definitely not what I want. Since this outpost doesn't have any landing pads, we just pick a spot and land. I probably could have picked a better spot that wouldn't risk the ship rolling over, but it worked out. Again, the placement not working right in the Aurora. This isn't the best ship to be doing deliveries with, as it has very limited space in the cabinet. As you'll see later, once I have all three boxes in here, it can get a little bit glitchy.
restricted facility. Trespassing will be treated according to local laws.
Engines are off.
And like I mentioned before, feel free to look around for loot boxes. Since I'm kind of a pack rat, I can't resist loot boxes. And you never know what you might find. Sometimes it has items that other players want that you can trade them. But let's get what we came here for. Aha, finally, placement worked. Now, if you do transfer some loot from the loot boxes to the local inventory, don't forget to transfer it to your ship. Don't be a scrub like me and leave it there.
Thank you.
This time I'm going to use a landing pad so I can refuel and repair.
Engines are off.
As I mentioned, when it gets crowded, sometimes the physics simulation gets glitchy. In this case, it shoved me right through the roof. Now that we have all our packages, we can head to our drop-off point. Now, something to just be aware of in general. If it's really windy, in this case, since the Aurora is a small ship, it's pretty light. When I turn off the engines, the wind picks it up and starts throwing it. Luckily, there wasn't much velocity yet when it hits the shipping crates, which start holding it in place. If I leave the ship here, it'll eventually take enough small damage from rubbing on the crates it would explode. So I'm going to bring it up alongside the building for it to act as a windbreaker. And it's just a matter of taking the boxes in for delivery, just one at a time. A little tip if you ever find yourself in a very windy area and need to walk around. If you crouch, you have less chance of being blown over or something like that. And that completes our 3-item delivery contract. After doing a couple more deliveries, you can unlock the next tier, which has 3-item pickup at a single bunker location, and then all 3 items are dropped off at a single location. So there's less travel involved. However, those have the possibility of running into hostile NPCs at the pickup site as they're in bunkers. So having an FPS weapon on you is recommended for those. If you made it all the way to the end here, I appreciate you taking the time to watch. I hope this video helped you out in some way, and I'll see you in the next one.